back with another edition of the Tyrone Shorter Show here on PowerCats TV. I'm your host, Robbie Donahoe. The Wildcats coming off a 35-7 victory on the road at Northeast Lauderdale as we kicked off division play the right way. We now welcome in your head coach of the Wildcats, Tyrone Shorter. Coach, always good to start off district play with a victory, especially doing it on the road, no matter who you're playing. So just recap the win. I know you mentioned before that you got to a fast start, but you didn't let that early touchdown deter the team going forward, scoring 35 unanswered.
No, we just made some mistakes. Our middle linebacker, Christian Hoppin, he just, you know, once we see something and he get a chance, he could be the quarterback on defense, and he changed the play, and it was a wrong play, and they broke a touchdown. But it was something that we can fix, and we fixed it right away, and he knew what he did wrong, and so, but we give him that right to change plays when, you know, I feel comfortable with him changing plays. And he made a mistake. He just changed the play, and he slanted right, and the play went left, and it broke for a touchdown. But we learned from that, and he did too. So, but it didn't rattle us. You know, our defense came back, and we settled down, and he put us in some good checks the rest of the night. So, you know, we were fine.
Offense scoring 35 points and doing it with relative ease. I mean, once again, it seemed like this offense is capable of putting up 50, 60 points, but you don't need to do that, it seems like. So just overall, offensively, it seems like things are starting to click a little more, especially with the running game as well.
It is, and it started with our offensive line. Those guys really from week one, you know, just to see those guys grow from week one for the nice of the game until now. You know, we made some changes. We came in and after that first week, we changed the whole offensive line up. We moved Vodashan from defense to offense. So we got better at that. But like you said, our offense can put up 50, 60 points if I allow them to. But it's not sportsmanship. I don't believe in running the score up on anybody. So, but we just do enough just to get the job done. And our kids, they're coming out, you know, they came out with a fast start. You know, our offense is clicking, our run game, our passing game. I want us to be balanced. And it starts with our offensive line. Those guys are doing a great job. And they got, you know, player of the week. You know, the whole entire offensive line got player of the week. I think we had over 320 yards rushing. We had over 100 and some yards passing. So, you know, I told them guys, the month of October, the month of November, we can run the football because the weather fit to get bad, fit to be nasty. So you're going to have to be able to run the football in this condition that we're going to face. And we can do that. You know, we're going to be in good shape.
We're kind of taking my job there, segueing to our A&E Insurance Agency Players of the Week. We tried to fit them all onto one screen. I think we somehow managed to do it. That's our offensive line. See Nasir Brown up top, Sicario Goss, Fred Parker, Vidashawn Yarbrough, Jay Miller, also a part of this five-man offensive line that was named our Players of the Week. I'm going to start with the two guys in front, Fred and Vidashawn. You guys were some of the two newcomers for this offensive line this year. Where do you think you've grown the most as a unit through these first seven games?
I think we got more physical.
How's that transpired? How's that happened over time then?
Working each and every practice, getting better, working.
Vidashawn, where do you think you guys have really grown as a unit?
Well, I think consistency over practice and hard work, like Fred said, just going together as a team.
I like it. All right. Nasir and Sicario, they were our two guys from last year's offensive line that are back this year. Nasir, I'm going to start with you. You were a member of that state championship team last year, starter on that offensive line. Where have you seen this offensive line take the next step from last year to this year so far?
I've seen sparks of this O's line look like last year's line, but in my opinion, we could be a lot better because we are more faster and athletic than last year's O-line to me.
I like that. All right. Sicario, from week one, that tough game against Noxubee, to now, where have you seen this offensive line really improve the most?
Really just in practice. Just like they say, you work hard in practice, you work hard in the game, you play harder. You feel me? You the better you do at practice, the better you're going to do in the game. The good stuff you do at practice, it goes over into a game. So it really, everything just started in practice.
Very nice. Now, what's y'all's favorite part of being an offensive lineman? What's the best part?
Because I know maybe nasty.
Being the nasty.
You gotta be nasty.
Being aggressive, put on their back. Nazir, what about you? I know y'all don't get the praise and love like you should, but now you got the spotlight here. What's the best part about being an offensive lineman?
To me, it's celebrating with your team in the end zone, your quarterback, your running back, your receiver, because you know on the inside you made that happen, but they made the play.
Some wise words right there. I like that. All right, two guys in the front. What's the expectation then for Friday? Because you got homecoming coming in, we got Choctaw Central coming in Friday. What's the expectation for Friday?
We trying to come in pounding the ball, pounding.
Bye, Sean.
Same he said, hit the ground hard.
I like it. All right, fellas, we appreciate the time. Congratulations once again on being our A&E Insurance Agency Players of the Week, and we look forward to seeing y'all mauling some more guys coming up on Friday.
Yes, sir.
And we now welcome back in Coach Shorter and Coach, that offensive line boy. They're a fun group, but they seem to be, when they need to be serious, though, they are serious.
They are serious. Shakaria Goss and Nazir, those two guys are the most funnest guys I've ever been around. They keep things going, especially Shakaria. He's just one of those kids that you love. He's just a country kid that, I mean, he's just fun. But all those guys, they begin to grow together and becoming a very good offensive line, and I love those guys. I like to go down there and watch them practice and watch them do everything. Coach Salas be on their tail, and just to watch them grow from week one to now, you know. And I told them that our offense, you know, it starts with them. If they're good on Friday night, we'll be good on Friday night.
I was going to mention Coach Salas. He's always seems like he's on those guys, and he gets the most out of them. So it's good to see how they're starting to put it all together, especially after that week one game, that loss at Knoxby. So now we turn our attention to the week that is. So homecoming week, distractions, everything that comes with it, fall break around the corner. So there's a lot that is going to be in the kids' minds going into Friday. And you mentioned it with me against Northeast Lauderdale is maybe the kids sometimes look too much at the record of who they're playing rather than what's on film. This is a Choctaw Central team that I think most people will see, well, Choctaw Central, not typically a football power team, but this is a team that's improved tremendously over the last year. And this is a team, I think, you know, that's going to give us all we can handle going into Friday.
It will. The more and more I watch films on these kids, I'm like, wow, because it's my first time ever watching film on Choctaw Central. Ever played against them, never had to watch film or anything on them. So I never knew what style of football that they play. But as I watch film on them, they're a gritty football team, and they get after it, you know. And they came up with a big win on Friday night against Kosciuszko. So they 1-0 in the division just like we are. So they are a scary football team because they're not going to quit. And then this week here, it's homecoming. I love homecoming, but as a coach, you know, you kind of hate homecoming because there's so many distractions, there's so much stuff going on, so many activities, and I keep telling our guys that homecoming not for football players. It's for the people that's coming back from home, it's for everybody else, and we the main event, though, you know. So, you know, on Friday night, you know, we cannot allow Choctaw to come in here and spoil the homecoming, because even though everything that's going on, everybody's going to remember that going to remember the game, the last event of homecoming. They're going to remember that.
We'll have plenty of festivities Thursday night for homecoming Friday. Again, 7 o'clock kickoff time at RE Hinze Stadium as we take on Choctaw Central. Also want to mention Monday night, 6 o'clock and 7 o'clock, our 7th and 8th grade Wildcat teams are playing for the Pro River Conference Championship games against Scott Central. So make sure you come to RE Hinze Stadium. Basically, if you want to camp out here Saturday, Sunday, maybe bring a TV, watch some football. We'll have plenty of football for you. I'm just kidding about that. Just be here Friday, be here Monday, cheer on the Wildcats to victory over Choctaw Central, and then Monday against Scott Central.
Because our 7th and our 8th grade team are, you know, the future are really bright. You know, I spent a lot of time with the 7th grade and the 8th grade team, and I love that those guys, and they play hard. And if you haven't seen those guys play Monday night, it's a good time, and they play in the championship. They both undefeated, so and Scott Central is very good too. So it should be a good football game on Monday night.
Speaking from experience, they are entertaining. You will get your money's worth when you see the Wildcats play coming up, not only Monday night, but Friday night as well. So we hope to see you at RE Hinze Stadium coming up Friday and Monday, cheering on your Wildcats. For Tyrone Shorter, I'm Robbie Donahoe. Thank you for watching. We'll see you this weekend.